everyone for making the effort to be here tonight. I know many of you are preoccupied wondering the status of your own properties. I also want to join Supervisor Potter and the others in thanking the tremendous service of CAL FIRE, U.S. Forestry, Office of Emergency Services. We had an opportunity to get a briefing at the Incident Command at Toro Park. They put together a city there overnight, and the reassuring thing, this is not the first time they've come together. We hear a lot of complaints about things in government that don't work. One thing that's working really well in this state, and unfortunately we have huge demand, is CAL FIRE. The coordination of the leadership team, these are officers who have worked together on other fires. Many of them have worked this area before. Many of them are from this area. They know all of the terrain. It's treacherous terrain. In the briefing this morning, we got the reassurance of more resources coming in. In response to my question, are there any resources you need that you don't have? The answer was an unequivocal no. We're getting everything we need. 50 more bulldozers came in today. U.S. Forestry processed the permits 2 days ago that allow the bulldozers into the U.S. Forestry region, so there's no holdup there. This is running as smoothly as can be expected. But as you heard in the briefing, the winds, the terrain, make this an ongoing, treacherous situation. The mantra of today's briefing is public safety and firefighter safety. So in response to questions of where are the aircraft, why are there firefighters on this ridge, all the decisions that are made by the incident command, the first decision is safety of residents and firefighters. So the best thing that we can all do is, has been said tonight, it's the first briefing of many. We're in the early stages, unfortunately, of a really tough fire. And the way that we reduce the risk is working together and respecting and protecting your neighbors and following the commands of firefighters and law enforcement. There will be opportunities in the days ahead to pursue issues of rebuilding, of who's gonna pay for what, but the concern right now is controlling the fire and protecting human life. My office, in coordination with Supervisor Potter and the Board of Supervisors, will be meeting tomorrow. We will be pursuing the Federal Management Assistance Grant, but that has no bearing on the resources that are here right now to fight the fire. That is who picks up the bill afterwards. It's not slowing down the response. So I just want to offer that reassurance. You'll hear the terms FMAG, Federal Management Assistance Grant. That is a process, but it doesn't slow or retard the response to the fire right now. My office can also be helpful to any of you who have been displaced, who have maybe left a driver's license behind. There's no issue that we won't try to help you with. I also want to acknowledge my staff, my district director, Nicole Charles. This is also her fourth fire, our fourth fire. Also, Toby obtained VF from my office. And I also want to thank Kathleen and Supervisor Potter's office. We've worked closely over the last 4 years. Again, there's unpredictability when you have this much fire on. The important thing, protect yourselves, protect your animals, and leave it up to the firefighters to protect your property. And again, I just want to thank the coordination that we saw this morning. I've had the pleasure of working with Chief Blue and other members of the team. This is what they do. This is what we support them to do. I'll just close on this. When I went to the assembly in 2008, the firefighting budget for CAL FIRE was about $50 million a year. This year it's about $950 million, just under $1 billion. And part of the reserve that we've protected in the budget will go to provide the resources necessary for public safety and firefighting. As you know, there's another big fire burning in Southern California right now, but there are adequate put sufficient resources to do what needs to be done here. Again, my office will be glad to help any of you if you have a problem, if you've been displaced. But the issue right now is public safety. Protect yourselves, respect the officers, and thank you for being here tonight.